come in handy.
I'm gonna go ahead now and turn the oven on. I will set it at 375 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm gonna try to convert that to Celsius and put that somewhere on the screen. But keep in mind that you can make this recipe on the stovetop as well. If you don't have an oven, you just need to cook it under really low heat and then put a cover on. But since I have an oven, I'm gonna go ahead and do that.
Now it's time to assemble our breakfast casserole. The very first step is to drain the canned fish. If you're using canned fish, make sure you drain out the water. We want to use as little water as possible. And then I'm gonna go ahead and just crack all the eggs. Remember, we're using 12 eggs, not 6. So the first 6 is to make the filling, which is basically what I'm doing right now. I'm preparing the filling for the casserole. And then you go ahead and season it according to your taste. I am adding salt to mine. I'm adding some white pepper. The salt that I used there was Himalayan pink salt. It just has more minerals than your regular salt. And then I just added some hot pepper flakes. Mix everything well. I just added some chia seeds. Chia seeds are high in omega-3 fatty acids as well. It's completely optional. You don't have to. I am just kicking up the nutrition a notch. Then I'm gonna go ahead and add my bell peppers, my onions, flake the fish, and then add it to the egg mixture. After adding the fish, go ahead and stir everything up to make sure that it is well incorporated and properly seasoned. I'm adding parsley. Again, you can substitute that with whatever herb you like or have on hand. It could be cilantro, it could be celery. So we're going to go ahead now and just grease our pan so that it doesn't stick. So the first layer of vegetables I'm adding is the sweet potatoes. That is what is going to take the longest time to cook. You just need a single layer of that. What I'm doing is seasoning as I go, adding more salt so that it is properly seasoned. Then I am layering with the filling that we just made, the egg and fish mixture. Remember that you can substitute that fish with chicken, with ground chicken, ground turkey, even ground beef. At this point, I'm adding almond flour. No, I didn't mention that in the ingredients, but this is just to soak up some of the extra water from the egg mixture. Completely optional, you don't have to include it. Then I'm adding another layer. This time I'm using the yellow squash, and again, season as you go. You get the idea. So it's vegetables layer with the mixture, and then and so on and so forth. What I'm adding there is the sweet bitter leaf. This is our version of kale, I strongly believe so. Sweet bitter leaf is not bitter, and that can be replaced with spinach or it can be omitted altogether. I'm just using every opportunity to pack in more nutrients. And then I'm topping it off now with jalapeno peppers. These peppers are hot, but not as hot as habanero peppers. And then adding my tomatoes on top. You would notice that at this point it is kind of a little dry on top. So what I'm doing is just adding more eggs to bind everything together. You're free to whisk the eggs if you want to, but it just works better for me this way. You know, see how pretty it looks. Final seasoning with my salt. Guys, I did not over salt this, trust me. It's just a little sprinkle here and there just to make sure that everything is properly seasoned. At this point, my casserole is ready to go in the oven. I'll bake this for at least 30 minutes. but it's up to you to watch and see how it's doing. What you're looking for is for the entire thing to be firm and not watery at any point. So just keep an eye. I'm sprinkling some cheese. This is completely optional. I use mozzarella cheese, and then I finished it off in the broiler for a couple of minutes. Just look at how pretty this looks. It tastes quite delicious. This makes about 8 to 12 servings, and remember that this keeps in the fridge, and so you can meal prep this and then just grab a piece for breakfast, for lunch. Absolutely be served with a small salad. You can add a quarter of an avocado for a complete meal. Guys, I really hope you do try this recipe. And if you do, I always like to hear back from you. This is a method. Again, it is a method. You can use whatever ingredients you have on hand to make it work for you. Thank you so much for watching. Let's continue the conversation in the comments. Let me know if you have any questions, concerns, or suggestions. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to like. Don't forget to share the video. Help me grow, guys. Thank you so much, and I will catch you in my next video. Stay safe, stay healthy. Bye-bye. Bye.